and anything from Suraj or Athiya that they would like to know about your work?
We need to join her studio one more.
I'm very happy he's coming to Ken's Corner because I live right here. So that's like a, I'm super excited for that.
But she'll still travel to Bandra.
Oh yes.
Okay, could kindly share with us also, being as professional on big screens and in the public eyes, celebrity status, how much is that pressure of fitness, how demanding is it now for you?
For me, it's the most important. I actually started training when I was really young, from my martial arts to my weight training and all of that. I don't know if I'm fit, but I would be as fit as I am right now, even if I would want to be a doctor or something else. I think fitness is the most important aspect for anybody, and it is amazing because it makes you feel so amazing after you see results, and it's a never-ending process. You keep learning so many things about your own body every second week. So yeah, it's a never-ending process, and this is something new which I want to try because it's really important for you to try new ways to work out.
Fitness is obviously extremely important. I think. For actors especially, because you have to look good on screen, but also as a person, I think you need to be fit, because it says a lot about the way, not only how you look, but how you feel. Your mind and body have to be in sync. And I think what's really important is that you don't need to look good for a role, but I think you need to be fit generally. And I think that's extremely important. It's okay if you're skinny, it's okay if you're fat. You just have to feel good about yourself and working out and be healthy and eating healthy. And everybody has different body types. There's no ideal body type. And I think that's very important for people to know, that you can be fit in different shapes and sizes.
Yasmin, we've been using, that's wonderful. Everyone's accepted as they are. Everyone's invited on the bus. Okay, Yasmin, something about this term and fundamental of Pilates. So could you kindly share with us, because it's a much used word and that's the foundation of the book.
My best explanation of Pilates is like Joseph Pilates, who's the founder of Pilates, used to say, he used to call his work contrology, which is where you take control of your mind and your body. You basically have control of your life. And to do that, what he did was he did all kinds of exercises. He was a martial arts man, he was a gymnast, he was a boxer, he did yoga, he did everything. And what I think he did is he put everything in together to create Pilates. And when you do Pilates, I mean, when you read it and you know you hear about it, it's a very Western term right now for our country. It's not gonna be, because from 10 years back to now, it's changed so much, and I can tell you, I can guarantee you that everyone's going to be doing it in the next 10 years, because it's such a beautiful form of exercise. It gives you strength without injury. It gives you strength without causing any harm. The weights you do are very gentle on your body, mechanisms, and it's very, very functional. In Pilates, we don't do any movements. I've done them, squats with the barbell, you know, you're doing sumo squats, you're doing the squats, but really, when are you using those squats in life? You know, you're not going to squat your way through your life. And even when you lunge, we lunge straight, whereas functionally you lunge with rotation. You lunge to reach something, you lunge to, you know, you reach up to get something. In the gym, we're very constricted in our movements. Pilates teaches you to do rotation, flexion, you know, stuff like that with resistance. So it's functionally training your body to move in the different directions. During knee surgery, we recuperate them through Pilates. We have people who come back after slip discs. We help them. Pregnancy, we've trained people during pregnancy. My gynec sitting here nodding her head at me. Dr. Ranjana Dhanu, thank you for coming. And post-pregnancy, every kind of body. My most fun is when a man who works out in the gym with really heavy weights and says, Pilates, okay, let's try it. I'll come into the gym. Give me a session. Let me see what it feels like. I love it because I make him do the most simple things which require concentration and control, and he can't do it. Give him a lot of weight and he can lift it, but you tweak it a little bit, and ask, not even flexibility. I'm not saying I'm challenging an inflexible person with flexibility. I'm just changing the routine a little. So yeah, it's a great form of exercise for each and everyone.
Gentle
is just a nice way of saying it. If you come into my studio, you'll
but
realize.
Challenging.
Yeah, like my clients tell me the first two classes, I'm like an angel. And then they see the devil in me.
Okay, we're going to give a very special opportunity for those of you who would like to take from the media an exclusive frame altogether. So we'll give you one more opportunity. Suraj and Atiya have some prior engagement to which they need to progress to. So we need to excuse them, but we're not going to release them without giving them a very special and deserving applause. So thank you very much on behalf of Crossword and everyone from the publishers, Penguin Random House.
I'm here for a book signing. I never ever thought in my life that I would be sitting in a bookstore signing a book. But this is one book I could be signing for because I've been involved with fitness for a very long time, and I'm really happy to know Yasmin now, and hopefully going to do some fitness sessions with her for her Pilates class.
There are some myths.
Not that any vegetarian can't be a bodybuilder. You need to have your chicken and fish. There are so many. There are supplements. There are whey protein. There's a lot more for everyone. Gavin, are you asking questions?
Gavin, you've trained many Bollywood A-listers. You've seen Suraj up close and personal. You've also known Salman Khan, I believe. Who has the best six-pack abs?
Than in six-pack abs. So for me, being fit has to come naturally rather than six-pack abs. Anyone can build six-pack abs with a lot of hard work and dedication. But to be fit is more important, because when you're fit, then to build six-pack abs isn't that difficult, which I'm sure it wasn't for Suraj, because he's always been fit. So it's just taking your body to that much more to get there. But the essence is six-pack is being fit and not six-pack abs.
A question, comment about Atiya and Suraj. Who do you think has the fittest body in Bollywood, male and female?
Male is Tiger Shroff. Female, I would say, is Deepika Padukone.
I think for me, the fittest male would be Akshay Kumar, because we've always spoken about this. He doesn't get fit for a role. He's just naturally fit, and he naturally has that body and that energy, and that he eats right. He has a healthy life. And the fittest actress, I would say Katrina. She has amazing.